It should come to no surprise that America has a big recycling problem. It's something that we as a country have been trying to curb, but to no avail. It seems like we are in a constant tug and pull relationship with recycling, where we take 2 steps forward and 10 steps back. I guess we have to find the root of the issue and then ask ourselves, how can we make sure more of our plastic is recycled? Well, let's start with a quick overview on recycling. When garbage pickup started, cities would separate reusable trash items from garbage, just like is done today. The cities then would sell the reusable trash to industries, and many people would save items to feed their animals. Once the 1920s hit, there wasn't a lot being recycled except for metal at scrapyards. So during this short period of time, there were not that many people recycling. During the early 1940s, when World War II hit, people were recycling everything. Nylons, tin cans, cooking fats, and even the tin and toothpaste tubes for war effort. By the 1960s, some of the first recycling programs that were connected to people's concern for the environment started to sprout. People were more outright about their passion for the environment and how we should protect it. However, besides the few people making the conscious decision themselves, the majority of the population still wasn't recycling. Most people didn't even think about reducing use of anything until a single problem arose. The landfills started to fill up in the 1970s. After World War II, landfill was the best and most popular option for disposal. Since 1960, recycling has been widely pushed for Americans to practice. We've made big changes when it comes to correct forms of disposal. Being that as of 2017, over 35% of the amount of waste going to landfills have gone from 94% in 1960 to 52% in 2017. Even though we were improving, in 2017, only 8% of plastic waste was recycled and only 27% of glass was recycled. There were arguments that pollution would never decrease. In 2018, America sort of made a drawback. China finally cut ties with the United States in taking our landfill and waste. There was an overwhelming amount of contaminated and soiled materials that was in the Chinese processing facilities. They stopped taking our waste to curb their own environmental damage. Unfortunately, after they stopped taking in our materials, Americans have been unable to pick up the slack. Cuts have even started for spending on recycling. Over the past year, cities started to mix recyclables and trash because the local trash collectors were understaffed and overwhelmed with the amounts of trash. Especially with the pandemic, it was very hard to keep track of everything going on. So to answer the question, what do we do? Well, first, we can start with looking into other countries that are accepting waste. Countries like Malaysia and Vietnam are still accepting waste, but as of right now, their systems are not as efficient and too small to handle our waste. Plus, the amount of our waste would eventually cause environmental issues in these countries, just like they did in China. One of the responses to the recycling problem is that there are attempts to build new facilities. This would help fill the gap we need when it comes to recycling. The company Pratt, which processes paper for New York City, recently opened 2 recycling facilities in the Midwest. This is one step in the right direction, yet there are several more to go. Another way to help our recycling issue is to stop wishful, or in other words, aspirational recycling. This is a term that is used in the waste management system to describe when people put something that is not recyclable in the recycle bin. Items like dirty diapers, garden hoses, string lights, and even bowling balls are not recyclable, yet every day they are placed with recyclable items. When things like this are done, it makes the process of recycling much harder. Once you put something that's not recyclable into a bin, the whole bin gets contaminated and is no longer in good use. Oftentimes, workers are forced to throw big batches away when they could have been used for something else, creating more waste. They are even stuck having to fish unrecyclable items out of their conveyor belts, which causes more costs and takes the process longer to finish. Something else that would help is the classic line, reduce, reuse, recycle. Especially the part of reducing. What you don't use will never end up in the ocean or a landfill. What is important to know is to educate people on what and what not to recycle. It's good to know to avoid recycling items made of mixed materials. To go coffee cups and cartons that held milk or beef stock are best to just throw away, being that they are not worth the trouble. Looking up how to recycle your items can also be a good method as well. So I know you're probably asking, what does chemistry have to do with this? The real question is, what doesn't chemistry have to do with recycling? Chemical recycling is known as the process by which a polymer is chemically reduced to its original monomer form so that it can be eventually be processed and remade into new plastic materials. This is called repolymerization. Chemical recycling has helped overcome some of the limits we had for traditional recycling and opens more options for where recycled plastics can be used. Another chemical process that has been helpful is pyrolysis, which is a process where solid waste is turned into synthetic crude oil, which can be refined into diesel, fuel, gasoline, heating oil, or waxes. This process allows non-recycled plastics into ultra-low sulfur diesel, which reduces greenhouse gas emissions by 14% and saves 96% in traditional energy. Gasification turns non-recycled materials from solid waste to synthesis gas, which can be used for electrical power generation or converted into fuel or chemical feedstocks. All three of these processes are part of advanced recycling. Advanced recycling uses chemical building blocks that make up the recycled plastic, which are recovered. The building blocks repolymerize, which give them new qualities like resin. There are still a ways to go in discussing how to properly recycle or even where to start. But thanks to modern technology and science, hopefully we can find ways to fix this issue of recycling so we can save our planet.